Hello everybody, welcome back to this DCS Liberation Campaign. So we are on turn number 20. Wow, can't believe we've done 20 missions so far. Pretty cool. As you can see, we have taken a few bases here. I think did we take back Nalchek that last turn? I think we did. So able to get that back, which is good for the old budget, which I've spent most of the money already replacing all of those airplanes we've been losing. So today's strategy is really to support a couple fronts. We got this front line. Hopefully we're going to take Gadada. They only have a few ground units, so I don't see a problem with us taking that today. So really the strategy today is to provide cap support on everything that's going on here. Still not pushing in for this mission. Now, what my mission today is to actually strike Mineral and Vodi. I will be taking a pair of F-16s out of Lukini or Tbilisi to strike the runway. So we do have rain today. It's overcast with rain. So I'm going to be using the radar to strike that runway, which has a bearing of 302. So the idea is me and my wingmen will hit that. There is some SAMs below or south of the site and west of the site, so we'll need to be careful. I do have a two-ship of F-15s providing fighter escort, and then we have a two-ship of S-16s with seed escort, so hopefully they can take care of this. SA-15 here and SA-8, I think there's a, yeah, SA-9 and SA-15, and then this is a SA-13 that's on next to the airport. So we're going to attack this pretty high. I am going to take in Mark 84s to strike the airport. So that is our plan today. Additionally, we don't have a lot of units at Mosdok or at Nalchek, so those will be providing some CAS support from some A-10s out of Beslan. I'm also advancing the Apaches here at Beslan up to Nalchek, so they can be closer to the front lines. Additionally, I've noticed some issues with both AWACS and the B1s and others taking off from some of these airports here. So I'm transferring all those units over to Tbilisi. It looks like there's a bigger runway and also better space for them to operate. So AWACS and the KC-135, the B-1s, and then I've also activated the B-52s over here as well. So I'm going to be using this as my heavy bombers and heavy planes operations. So that is the strategy for today. Other than that, just a lot of cap support, both for the carrier group and also out of Kobaleti here with the F-15s. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump into the game, and I will see you in a second. Hello, and welcome to the game. Alright, yep, crappy weather. So let's get this bird started up. Close that up so nothing gets wet. Looks like we've got 267 is on our comms, comm 1, channel 1, tech end 25 x-ray, and looks, well, as far as this says, runway 31. And we got 2977. Okay. 267, right. 267.
Chevy 1-1, request startup.
Chevy 1-1, Martini, clear for startup. Wind 300 at 8 meters per second.
Chevy
20%. SEC is out. There's two. This is the first time I've flown out of this airport. Very cool. Good engine start. Cap support today.
IFS.
I'll do the normal alignment because we are part of a package today, so timing doesn't matter. I do believe I saw waypoint 7 is bullseye today. Joker's 4600. I will use that. So we're 1,500 feet. I'll just watch the flight control system do its thing. Yep, pretty cool, huh? Alright, we better get to work. Where were we? Use program one for my strike today, so I both want to have chaff and flares popping when I'm dropping into there. I usually just do heavy chaff on program one, but I might forget. So it looks pretty good. Program two. Flights on 116. Yep, flights on 116. Also, on my notes page, I also put some information about our strike today. So we do want to come in from 302, and at the base we have four SU-23s, and then we have SA-15, SA-9 south of base, around 4 miles. And a typo there, that should be SA-13 west of the base, about 3 miles. So those are our threats around the base. Very good. Let's go ahead and align our helmet mounted display. Oops. Looks good. Let's take a peek at the F-10. I just want to see where. Okay, so we're taking off runway 31. So we're going to hang a left. Go ahead and taxi out this way. Guess we could come out here and taxi that way. Let's do that. All right, takeoff time at 7:18 local time. We're going to be pushing at 7:26 at waypoint 1. And then join our package at 7:37 at waypoint 2. So it's a little bit of jaunt to get there. So 11 minutes. Yep. Yeah. Okay. I haven't dropped some Mark 84s in a long time. This will be fun. Going old school. All right, just waiting for that alignment. 26. The elevation at the airport today is also around 1,500 feet at our strike location, so I'll have to watch that. So we're going to be coming out of the clouds. Who knows? Maybe it'll clear up by the time we get there. Let's go ahead and do a ripple. And we want a spacing mode. 50 feet. Two singles, 150 feet, release angle 45. No, we want the release angle of 30. Yeah, that's better. And that's on CCIP program 2. 50 feet. And again, the release angle is 30 feet. That's good. So either if I do a CCRP or CCIP, we'll both have the spacing of 150 feet with a double release. Excellent. Okay, we're almost there. How are we doing on timing? Pretty good.
Lochina, Chevy 1-1. Request taxi to runway.
Lochina. That was called Lochini. Who knows? Oh yeah, these guys are taxiing. This is probably my seat escort. Oh yeah. All right, so they're just texting that. Okay, we'll do the same. So we're going to be using the air-to-ground radar to strike this today. And what is it, 302? Yep. Let's go ahead and program that in right now. Perfect. So waypoint 4. Nope, waypoint 4 is our strike. So waypoint 4, that should be dead on. I guess technically in the Viper you call it steer points, but that's all right. I think we're safe to go ahead and taxi. Let's force the issue.
Locina, Chevy, 1-1. Request taxi to runway.
Rolling.
Locini. I need some windshield wipers. Two's being all technical and taking off. Two's back there a little bit. That's pretty cool. That's my cap and my seat escort. Very nice. We'll wait just a sec for two.
Chechina. Chevy 1-1. Request takeoff.
Friend, you just gave me clearance, sir. Time is 26 after. And let there be light. Dig in the clouds. There's two. It's quite beautiful. Alright, there's my package doing their orbit around waypoint one. That's a good sign. Minutes to push time. Affirm. Saddle up, too. 250 miles, huh? Not a threat. How are we doing on fuel? 10,700. Our seat escort. No, those are F-15s. That's our cap. That's our fighter escort. Alright, 2 minutes push time. Activity going on. I'm really trying not to look at it. I'm sure there's a way to disable that. But because I plan all the missions, I like to know how things are going. There's two struggling to get up with me. So we need to be at waypoint 2 at 7:37. So this says 12 minutes to get there. We're still turning around. We'll speed up a little bit. So cool. So look, my push time is their push time, so they should be pushing a waypoint too as well. 7:37. I'm a little bit behind, that's okay too.
Flight, go trail.
Good boy. Good. Looks like everybody's pushing. Excellent.
1037.
How good our targeting pod is going to be today. Not with the weather as it is, so use our radar to lock up on that sucker. But let's get waypoint 2 first. And it's 7:37, eight minutes out. Yeah, I'm a little bit behind. Use the cruise page, time on target, so we need to speed up a little bit. We don't want to get ahead of our package though. See if I can see two. Time on target is telling us we're going to be there at waypoint 3 at 38 after. Yeah, so we're about a minute behind. That's okay. I don't want to juice up. Cool little rainbow effect right there. Miles.
Chevy 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 2D8 at 14 under 30 at 15,000 knots.
So as soon as we drop, we want to push right, because we don't want to get in those salmon envelopes. Which of those are our two front lines? Look good, guys. Alright, 9,200 pounds. Two hundred forty miles. Not too concerned. Well, we're about a minute late. But it looks like the whole package is late. So they're pushing waypoint 3, so we will do the same. Who are you? Let's do this. Waypoint 4, go weapons arm, air to ground. MiG-31's up. Pick out the runway on the radar here. Not yet. Alright, starting to pop, starting to get visual on it.
Request bogey dope.
Chevy 1-1.
40, 250. I think we're all right.
Counter.
Come on.
Counter.
I think I'm getting it. Roll in. Oh yeah, got some bogeys up. Oh. Come on guys, sanitize. Garbage.
Counter.
Spending too much time trying to get locked up on radar. I missed my approach. Take care of that bandit.
Counter.
It's just one. Fox 3. I don't know why he's not launching on me. Oh, there's the other one.
Counter.
Up my calf support. Nice. Trailer guy fired. Doing this with two Mark 84s in here. Ah, baby.
flare.
All right, sanitize. See if we can sneak in under these clouds. Oh, two's gone. Nope, two dropped. He's going home.
Chevy 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 2-7.
8 miles. Oh yeah, I think we're clear to get under the clouds. Oh yeah, should be good.
Altitude.
Affirmative. Well, go home, sir. Oh, there it is. And you are about to have a bad day.
Counter,
Cat, Blair. Nope, we want to go to the right.
Cat, Blair.
Nice, Blair. Two hits.
Counter.
God dang it. The F2. He's pinging me, MiG-31.
Cat, Blair.
Oh, my bomb's hit.
Counter.
6,000 pounds.
Counter.
Chevy 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bravo 254, Fort 170, at 3,000 knots.
Six 300 pounds. I don't know what too happened. Looks like he probably ran out of fuel. Yeah, the same amount of fuel as me. Alright, gratuitous flyby time. Whoops. Hope I don't need those. We had a good strike. Hopefully, only the two bombs were enough. put that runway out of commission. Go to Cat 1 now. Hits. Nice. Two aircraft down. Excellent. Right, so we have 41. We're 15 minutes out. All right, so let me go ahead and hit pause here, and I will see you in a second when we're getting onto approach. All right, welcome back. We're getting close to approach for mineral and boat. Yeah, where am I talking? Bikini. So let's go ahead and switch over to our comms.
Bikini, Chevy 1-1, inbound.
Runway 31-28. 812. Oops. Is that correct? I do believe so. So I want to know what Bingo is in our wingman. 100 pounds? Seems as soon as they call that, they're ejecting. Land 1.6. break in the clouds. Looks like we'll be all right for landing. Visual, sir.
Gina, Chevy, 1-1, request landing.
Maybe it will be visual. High ceiling. Excellent.
Altitude.
Affirmative. Excellent. A little high on the approach right now. So here's the... All right, Viper tip of the day. Here's your 3-degree glide slope when your gear's down. And that should be on your threshold. And your pappies are all white right now. There you go, there's one red. There's two red. 3 green. Stalled it right there at the end. Come on. Yep, didn't make it. All right, successful landing. I think we had a successful strike. Lost two. Not sure what happened there. But ejected. So, all right. So let's go ahead and shut it down here, and I will see you in the debrief. All right, welcome back. We are in debrief. So here are the results from today. 31 aircraft were destroyed. 33 frontline units destroyed, 2 ground units lost in the objective area, and 1 base captured event. I believe I did take a base there, so let's go ahead and accept the results. And yes, God, those Eagles just get lost. We lost 2 Harriers, lost 4 Eagles, 2 A-10s were lost, 2 Tomcats, and 4 Hornets. Bummer. And here's my wingman. We lost 6 Abrams. Ouch. In the They lost 16 Foxhounds, and the rest were all those frontline units. So, ouch, man, we were losing a lot of planes. So let's go ahead and see what base we've captured. And yes, we got Gadada. Fantastic. So that pushes up to 754 million per turn. I will use that money. maybe put in a SAM-site Patriot system here. Give us more cover. Coverage. And let's see. Oh, looks like my strike was not successful. So the runway is operational. That means all those MiG-31s are now up and running close to our front line. Oh, that's troublesome. So we're going to have to do some business up here with some cap. And maybe put another strike on there. But we do have our main, our heavy lifters. Where's those B1s? Yeah, the B1s are here. Oh, that's, yep, B1s are here. I think I will get a couple B-52s now. And maybe move up these F-16s up here. So that will be our next tasking for the day. So with that, let's go ahead and finish this up. And thanks for joining today. And thanks for all watching. All right, you take care. Bye-bye.